didn't make that up. I didn't make that up.
Yeah, I heard the flow. I know what you was talking about.
I didn't make that lyric up.
You listen to Destiny's Child, huh? You love some Destiny's Child. All right,
I just like that song. That song is so good.
Pretty good. So we got Fudo Johnny versus Knuckle Dude. Knuckle Dude coming off a hot second place at ECT. Lost the finals to Punk in a G mirror.
That's right.
I was actually very shocked. I wouldn't say shocked. Like, I wasn't shocked at the disrespect factor. I was shocked that Punk was actually able to do it.
Yeah, but Punk, you know, he's like that. He wants to troll you.
Definitely asked him, like, yo, why you pick G? He's like, you know what? I figured, you know, do's and losers, I'm a winner. Of course, I'm a winner. So I just, you know, just wanted to give it a shot. If I lost the first set, then I would have just picked either Colleen or Karen. But that's it.
Man.
But that was definitely Punk's answer, of course. But speaking of a strong Karen, of course, Johnny. The last time I seen him, he had an explosive
final round.
That was like the real last time I really saw him.
And really, honestly,
attention to his play.
I mean, when you look at it, me and Dave were talking about this earlier. He has 365 points, so he basically has 1 point for pretty much every day of the year right now. But the thing is, 200 of them came from final round. So since then, he's gotten even less than half. Like, he hasn't even been able to double the score. He's been getting 17th places at a lot of events. So he's just been outside of the points so many times.
Yeah, he's right on 37.
Yeah, so he's on 30. So he's trying to get up there right now. So if he can have a good run here, and if he can get, like, 200 points, I mean, that would only put him at 565. So he would still be pretty far. He needs to get a lot of points. This is rough. This is actually tough.
Why is it? I am the world president.
Man, the one guy that I want to see make it into the top 32 is definitely Mandrake. Mandrake.
Oh, yeah.
Very big fan of that Urien.
He's also, this mouse is dying on me here.
I think the mouse is dead, James. Yeah. Oh, no, we got it.
I got to yell at David about that to be like, man, giving me defective mice here.
It was all part of the plan, James, to get you trigger herd.
Yeah, so, I mean, for rankings, for premieres, I'm sorry, you get 700 for first place. Second place, you get 350. So, yeah, 700 points obviously would catapult anybody right now into the top, unless, of course, you know, it's someone like Fudo who already has all the points, right? But even if Johnny can get, like, for example, second place, that would actually give him a ton of points as well.
We'll see, man. There's too many killers in this building. Those second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh places is not promised to nobody.
Yeah. But Knuckle Dude really has been sticking with that G.
Yeah, he's definitely been very, very consistent with the G pick. I'm actually surprised that he would pick G against a character like Karen. And I feel like, though, if you could check her dashes and you can stay at those ranges at all times where she needs to be, I feel like the matchup is fine.
Well, one of the things that I do like about G in this matchup is his normals are really good. He has good far-reaching normals. He can kind of keep up with Karen a little bit. But I believe Johnny just beat Smug earlier
in the same match.
Yeah. So, yeah, I think Johnny is very comfortable in this matchup.
That's just the fact, like, you know, when I see a character, especially from Knuckle Dude, you know what I mean? He has the Guile. Guile does pretty well against Karen. Yeah. You know what I mean? Of course, Armika as well.
Guile's an interesting one because it feels like he should do well, but then she can always command dash through those sonic booms, which is a pain. The EX command dash, I should say.
I like that. The spaced out wheel kicks. Nice. No, you're not going anywhere. Wow, the wall. Knuckle Dude. Okay, another wheel kick. Just wearing him down little by little. There it is. You're not trying to dash nowhere. Commando, that might be stunned.
Oh, yeah, you're stunned at this point in time. Now, he should have enough meter to spend right here. Oh, he chooses not to spend it because he figures he has a big enough life lead that he can drain something here. But look at that adjustment from Knuckle Dude. Wow.
Straight boot and ass, just to talk about, just to represent bus ass, a straight boot.
Yeah, what he decided to do that round was he decided to hold a distance just like one body away and just hold that distance, not go in too hard and try to catch her moving forward. And I think now he's done that.
Oh, that was godlike. Of course, Johnny thinking it was a command throw, so he back dash.
Light it up.
Give him everything. Yo, double perfect? Stop.
Light it up.
Oh my goodness. Living his life like it's golden. It is Knuckle Dude. That was bus ass. That is, when it's a double B, that we just gotta let it go. It's bus ass, guys.
Yeah, and look how happy that wallet is right now. Good job, Knuckle Dude. I'm rooting for you. You win, you can put more money in me.
I just look at the wallet and I just hear Arturo's voice.
Okay, maybe we can get Arturo to voice it too.
Yo, blow up? Yo, blow up? I'll do the Nerd Josh version. Yo, cash, my wallet. My wallet. God damn, I wasn't watching. We're here talking about it. You know, geez, it's a solid thing. No,
yeah.
It's a solid win for G. How about that one?
And what's crazy about that, double perfect means that neither round, KnuckleDew relied on the V-trigger, which is like one of his best tools, right? I mean, that's how he gets all of his robbery victories. But it's just, he didn't even need it. Two perfects.
And that's how strong a character G can be. A lot of people has been sleeping on this character. For whatever reason.
When he first came out, I still remember David was just talking about, like, this character is so good. And people were like, eh. And it's just like, really? And
yeah.
Now here he is. He's busting ass all over the place.
Yeah, you know what, though? Ultra David did say this, though. One thing that always resonated with me about G is that he does have the best V trigger in the game.
Yeah.
That's what he keeps saying.
Mm-hmm. And how can you argue with that, dude? Because a lot of times when people activate V triggers, they get two uses of something.
Yes.
He gets like seven of them on an average, you know? It's just like, it's crazy.
And it just helps amplify his moves as well.
But look at this. Oh, no! That move is so fast. Move is so fast, and they let you cancel it into a V trigger.
He is mashing on backdash. That's one thing about Johnny. He'll either mash on backdash or he'll wake up with the reversal every single time. Like, that's definitely his defensive option. He barely blocks. Obviously, like, situations like cross-ups and stuff like that, he'll block. But literally on his knockdown, on his wake up, you either wake up DP or backdash most of the time. Specifically on commando characters.
Wow, because blocking is such a dangerous thing in this game.
I still love this stage, actually. Okay. Looked like he was expecting another standard
spin. It's like the punk rocker guy, Black. He's playing the Street Fighter V guitar. It's the vibe.
Like I was talking to the master. Let me tell you something, old man. Back in my day. Got some good fights, but what an angle.
Oh, nice
class.
Dash forward just to get that hit in there. But now, with that, yep, here we go. V trigger activated. No, regular.
Oh!
Back breaker. Oh! Oh, he missed it. And that's going to give Johnny a chance to get that throw in there. Wow. Yeah, V reversal. Doesn't want to deal with the mix up. Oh, but you're not going to be reversal. Is he dead? Can he? Oh, no, he missed.
Look at that. Holding up forward. Johnny wants no part of that corner.
Yeah,
still trying
you're
to
right. Oh, he got to the other side. He wasn't expecting it. KnuckleDew steals that round from Johnny.
Okay, dude, 211. Wow, with the Michael Jackson at the end? I didn't even know he got that. Oh, spend that cash. All the way to the corner we go. Johnny looking comfortable again. We need to tie this up, Johnny. Oh, no. What a weird angle. It's like he lifts up his legs, so like there's like no hurt box in. Oh, man, that is violent.
Oh, good, but that was not going to combo into the fireball.
Oh, bully mode. Stop.
Oh, yeah, he was just looking for the stun, and guess what? He's got all that meter.
Dang.
Light him up.
Magnetic shockwave.
Oh, and there it is. KnuckleDew, after losing the first round in both games, I mean, for the first round in both games made it look like Johnny had it all on lock and all the reads and everything like that. But then KnuckleDew just, I mean, he's always been one of the best players at adjusting. You know, he'll lose a round and then all of a sudden he just figures it out and then he can take you down.